Mr. Cherry, we miss you down here in Boston, man. I know you're doing Coach's Corner up north there. We love it whenever we can catch it. And, you know, I wish you had jumped in my sweep when you were here for the Middleton retirement. But, you know, c'est la vie. Your friend's got my number. Give me a call next time.
And there's Mary Grinch. Now, listen, that's Bob, the cab driver. He might not be able to see us, but he can get these two things. Okay, Amazon. All right, let's go.
Thomas Chabot, another one. 32 points now.
32 points. And does he have a zinger from the point? Thomas Chabot, watch this guy go. Like, bang. I mean, he's really got. You know why? He's playing a lot there because Erickson is gone. Look at that. Look at that beauty. Nobody checking him, eh? 32 points, leading the league.
And they have, obviously, injury woes. When you were down for Middleton's event, what was the question?
Oh, yeah. Everywhere I go, I said, 13 defensemen. They played 13 defense, and they said, how come you guys were never? We were the guys that give the energy.
Injury. I got you. Okay. Let's go to
Charlie
McAvoy. I'm a pronunciation expert.
All right, now watch this here.
McAvoy.
Watch what Marner sucks him in here. Look, he knew he was going to get hit there. And so what is he supposed to do? And he gets hit again. Marner sucked him in. But you know the problem is you might get a defenseman that is not as nice as him that really drives him in. He knew he sucked him in. What he should have done, kids, what you do, you can't hit him anymore because Marner, he proved it there. He was still getting in the second one. You take your stick like that and you hold him in there. What he says is go like that and hold him. The bear hug can't do that anymore. Just take and push him in like that. Don't get the penalty. You do that, they'll take the dive like Marner did there. All right.
You always say Marner never gets hurt because he's wary out there.
Wait, listen, we've got a little thing going here. He's a little guy like that, not going. But we got some hits. We're going to show the hits right off the bat. And I want everybody to take a look at who gets hit here. Look, take a look. What do they have in common? Never mind that one. But this here one, what do they have in common? See how the guy, what do they have in common? There's Martin. See that there. Now.
Cromwell on both, by the way, Don.
But Cromwell.
Honestly, tonight. Was
yes, but Cromwell, he said he learned his hockey from Don Cherry's video. Huh. He did say that. Yeah, Rock 'em, Sock 'em. You know, the one I showed, that's for sale. Okay,
well,
last one.
Makes a lot of sense.
Yeah, and he's the guy that stepped in. There's Dumba. We showed him last week. Now, what is it? What do these guys have in common? And I'd have to say that you were the guy that thought this up, not me. So yeah, I'm not prejudiced. You know what it was?
And I am. Is that what you're hinting?
Yeah, you're the guy that brought it up. No, I.
It's to support your idea.
Support my idea. It was good. Is that they're all European, and the big thing.
Or American, or just not
American.
Raised in our CHL.
Matthews. He grew up in Arizona where they don't hit. He goes to Sweden or Switzerland or one of those places. The ice volleys over there. Mm-hmm. They don't hit. He doesn't know how to protect himself, and neither do those
well.
Guys.
Not as well, right. I mean, yeah.
I say he doesn't know how to protect himself because he was never hit. Now, you take Marner, ever since he's a little boy, everybody was after him all the time. Same as St. Louis, MVP, Hall of Famer. They're always, he knows, you never see him hurt. He does a dumb thing there. You never see, because he knows how to protect himself. They do not, you people that don't want hitting in hockey, this is the result. And Marner, he keeps that stuff out, head first in the boards. He's going to get some guy like Cromwell. He won't be so kind. All right.
Well, actually, let's do Patrick Laine right now, since you're on that wavelength, because he got dinged by Nolan in the pack, and he was in it with Robert Bortuzzo.
I got a little suggestion for Laine. He is five-goal scorer guy. He's got to stop this here. Got to stop this here. There's a guy we met in the airport. He's a good guy.
Bortuzzo.
Yeah. But he's got to stop stuff like that. And I'm going to tell you, watch the block shot, Bortuzzo. What a guy he is, eh? I guess St. Louis, I can't understand they're not doing better with guys like him. Anyhow, I'm going to continue. Lafleur, he used to take it just a thing. He would never look at anybody. He wouldn't go after anybody. You see how the cross-check like that? It goes. Lafleur wouldn't look at anybody, and that's why he got 52 gold. Nobody touched him. B, you got Laine, you got to be like Lafleur, and you'll be a lot better off than going after guys like Bortuzzo. Good guy. All right.
And obviously, Don Ryan Lomberg steps in for Backlund in the game when Dumba had the big hit.
He got two hit. I'm really disappointed in Dumba. He really turned. If you're going to step in and you hit guys like that, you have to step up. Now, Lomberg goes after you. I know he goes down, but doesn't make many turtles like that. You know, I'm really disappointed in Dumba like that. If you're going to step up and you're going to hit guys like that, And I like that Lomberg, eh? He just been called up. He gets two games, one for leaving the bench and one for being an instigator, 2, 5, and a 10. At least he shows up. That's why Calgary, you hit a guy from Calgary, boy. I don't care who it is. And you missed Giordano tonight, too. You hit a guy from Calgary. Somebody's going to step in there and take care of you. That's why they're doing so good.
Dumpins, this is a big thing with you.
Now, listen, hold it. I know everybody chip in. Call it chip in. Sounds okay. Better, dump in. Chip ins. Now, you don't, a 3-on-3, you never chip it in. You never, 4-on-4, you never chip it in. 3-on-2, you never chip it in. But when the wingers are back, you chip it in. Now, everybody, we got a little thing here. Put it in deep. Watch the guy. This is an interview. You know those interviews they do, ask them a question. Watch this. Watch this. Put it in deep.
We're skating better and, you know, getting pucks deep.
Putting the puck deep.
Put pucks in deep.
He's chipping pucks. He's getting pucks deep.
Getting a lot of pucks deep.
Get pucks deep.
Just put the puck deep.
Getting pucks out. Getting pucks deep.
Get pucks deep. Wear them down.
Get pucks in.
Pucks in.
Pucks in deep.
Puck deep.
Pucks deep.
Keep getting pucks deep and, you know, deep.
So I'm right again. I belong to the players. Now watch this here. Watch the other night, Edmonton. Watch this here. They get it. They'll lose it at the blue line, right? And the guy puts it down. Now they got the goalie out. Watch what they do. My son, Tim, they put it in and watch what happens. You go in there, you get the puck, you put it back to the point, and you get a tying goal. It's funny how they dump it in or chip it in, as they say, when the goalie's out. It's because the goalie's in there. The Bruins, we used to do it all the time, all the time. And when I played, the one thing I liked is when the guy would fool around at the blue line. I hated when they dumped it in my corner because I had to go in and get my brains pounded out. 3-on-3, never. 4-on-4, never. 3-on-2, never. When the wingers are back, the goalie's out, you put it in. All right, now, we have a great little thing. You set it up.
No, you do it. The Humble Broncos were here as guests of Jim Thompson and the Aurora Tigers. What a great 3 days they've had. They're up right now in Aurora having a ball on the Rogers Hometown Hockey Studio.
Let's see there's the picture of you, Hometown Hockey, Aurora. Yeah. Oh, you got to show. Okay.
This is right now. Yeah. Doing our opening for tomorrow.
And Xavier Lebel, Jacob Wasserman, Ryan Straczynski, and Lane Matterchuk. And there they are that in Aurora. I know you had to put it on that. Jim Thompson bought them out. And God love them. I mean, when I was there, when I was with the guys, there's something when you're at the... it really chokes you up when you're there. And you know... Oh, Chris Chelsea, we're going to talk about him. He was in the punch-out at Pia Stan. He remember Brian Williams when I had the little goal. He was there, and his son was killed in the thing, but he was there. We're going to show that. Can we show that one again? I would like to, if you show the one at the Hockey Hall of Fame, and the left-hand side, there was the one, yeah. Oh, there he is, and the left-hand side, and there he is with his thumbs up. He was at the punch-out at Pia Stan, and he appreciated because all the guys buried everybody, and that was the one. It didn't, and
Jackson's dead. Great guys. God love you, Jackson, and the Humboldt Broncos. Force field of good around us.